prophesied, because we walked those country roads all night long. We continued doing that until Fajr. And when the sun started coming up, I'm telling him, oh, it's time for you to pray. Look, look. He said, I'll be all right. No, it's okay. I said, but there's sun, you know, there's light. He said, it's time. Don't panic. And while he was doing that, I realized it's time for me to stop trying to push on other people what I think or what I feel. It's time for me to deal with it inside. And this is the key, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam. This is the key. The muftah is inside, not outside. And when I went behind my father's house and I found a piece of board back there, big board, you know, little shelter over it, nobody could see me, but the law. I put my head down on that board the same way I had seen the Muslim place his head, the same direction toward the east. And in that position with my head on the ground, I said these words, oh God, if you're there, guide me. I couldn't think of anything else to say. You sit here tonight, you know this is not a guy that has a problem coming up with words. Yet on that occasion, that's all I could say. Nothing else came into my mind. But those words echoed and echoed and echoed through my heart, even till today. Guide me. And Allah said in the Quran, "Ihdinu siratal mustaqim." When I raised up my head, I knew what I had to do. I knew exactly what I needed to do. I needed to declare publicly that I believe there really is only one God. He has no partners. And that Muhammad ibn Abdullah is his last and his final messenger to deliver that message. And that Isa, Jesus, was also the Messiah, Masihi, messenger, and prophet of Allah. So I went in to my Egyptian friend, and the new Muslim, ex-priest, obviously the church didn't need him anymore. And in front of those two, I swallowed. And I tried to say the words in Arabic, and I was shaking. And as I was saying it, I could feel the tears start to run down my face. Because I knew what it meant. I understood it. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Immediately after that, my wife took her shahada too. And entered Islam. The whole story, just sum it up a little bit later on. My father also entered into Islam. My stepmother followed just before she died. She said, there can only be one God. Jesus can't be a God or a son of a God. Has to be a messenger. So therefore, Muhammad must be a messenger. She said that in July and died in October. May Allah accept it from her. Ameen. Since then, I've seen many priests, even bishop, archbishop, ministers, pastors, reverends, elders, nuns, and even one called discipler from the Methodist Church enter into Islam. Many of their stories are on our website. You can see them. We have videos there. You can listen to them tell their story. It's called Islam Yesterday. You heard me mention one website, Islam Tomorrow? I liked it so much I decided to get Islam Yesterday, and that's where we put all the programs we did before, IslamYesterday.com. But then I needed something a little bit more inclusive, so I also have IslamAlways.com. Really. And we just opened a new one called ChatIslam.com. You can go there 24 hours a day. Our websites are open 24 hours a day and always plenty of free parking.
Before I leave the stage tonight, I would like to just give some nasiha or advice to us, and I hope Allah will accept this. He says in his book, you don't guide whom you love, but Allah guides who he wills. He asked us to deliver a message. He told us to go out and give dawah to the people, to invite them with a message of what? Worship God without partners. Yes? Is that the message? Try to keep that in mind when we deliver it. Because he also said, La ikraha fi din. We can't force anybody. Islam never spread by the sword. And it doesn't spread by any other weapon either. It spreads by truth. If you consider truth to be a weapon, then consider what Allah said about it. وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقَّ. This is in Surah Al-Isra. And say the truth has come and destroyed all the falsehood, because it will always destroy the falsehood. So let us work together. This is my advice, suggestion. Let's see how. Let us work together to live as Muslims, to be all we can be, and let that be an example for the people. And then when we talk to them, we can be proud to say, come be like us. Come be like us. May Allah accept your Islam. May Allah accept from me, from all of us and all the people. May He save all the people from the hellfire. Ameen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, who already challenged me. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.